Dr. Jerry O'Daniel's ability to warmly relate to his patients and the skill he's perfected as a plastic surgeon makes him one of the most respected and sought-after plastic surgeons in Louisville. Let's find out more about Dr. Jerry O'Daniel and his practice.
I've been in practice in Louisville, Kentucky since 1993. I do predominantly aesthetic surgery. I do reconstructive surgery for children with birth defects, and I do reconstructive surgery after facial cancers that the dermatologists remove the cancer and were available for the reconstruction. But the overwhelming majority of our practice is consumed by aesthetic enhancement and aesthetic rejuvenation of the face and the body. We have a major focus in facial surgery just by nature of my training and background, and now emphasis of my practice for the last 16 years. It's led to a very healthy practice, which includes facelifts and rhinoplasties, eyelid surgery. We do a significant amount of breast aesthetic surgery and body contouring surgery. You know, breast augmentation still represents one of the most common operations we see in our practice. The patients range from teenagers who have developmental deformities to the older patient who has lost her breast tissue secondary to age and having had children. We also are seeing the patient who wants just a plain aesthetic enhancement in the size of the breast. The most recent thing we're seeing in breast augmentation in the recent years is reintroduction of silicone implants. I was essentially raised, if you will, to do silicone implants in the 1980s, and then abruptly in 1992, silicone was taken from the market, and we were left with saline implants at that time, and developed a very healthy knowledge and usage of saline implants until 2006, when the FDA, through their judgment and intensive research, determined that silicone implants, in fact, were safe for use in cosmetic surgery. Since 2006, we're dealing with new polymers of silicone. We're utilizing silicone that's gel. It's been released for use across the board. There's been limited release for what's called cohesive implants, where you actually cut the gel implant in half and the silicone on the inside remains on the inside in a semi-solid state. That is on the verge of being introduced to full market use across the board for cosmetic enhancement of the breast. Body contouring surgery is something that we're all interested in. No matter how much you exercise, how well you eat, you choose your diet, you're still gonna have areas that concern you. But the reality is most people aren't over-anxious to exercise, and they're a little more liberal with their diet, and so they're gonna have areas that are gonna be of concern and seek treatment for this. This is a great example of an individual who is 2 months after a tightening of her abdominal musculature, where you can see there's bulging from her children, and then we use the laser to sculpt the fat and the skin, giving her a more sleek and uniform, flatter abdomen. We also reduced it on the hips, which reduces the size of the waist and gives a more flowing shape to the outer outlines of the body. We're continually trying to find new ways to reshape the body with shorter downtimes, with more predictable outcomes. The most recent advances in body contouring surgery have been the introduction of lasers that melt fat. We have all different types of lasers, different wavelengths that we're using, and each one has its advantages and disadvantages. I've been very fortunate to be picked by a company out of South Korea to utilize a new laser that recently received FDA approval for lipolysis. Lipolysis means you melt the fat. The laser itself is specific to fat and the water surrounding the fat, and the energy is less absorbed by the skin. What that means is the laser is less likely to burn the skin while it melts the fat. Those have been the complications that we've seen with the previously introduced lasers, and this company now has come up with a new wavelength that will prevent those problems. I've had the opportunity to use this laser for a large number of liposuctions, and what I have witnessed is a more rapid recovery, ability to better sculpt the soft tissue, and I'm seeing shrinking effect from the liposuction. particularly in areas that previously with classic liposuction were questionable, in particular the outer arms. And a lady who has skin that's starting to age and she has fullness in her outer arms, and most women will complain about the arms, I've seen the skin responding beautifully to the laser with shrinkage. I'm using it in conjunction on abdomens where a lady's had children, and we'll do a skin excision at the bottom of the abdomen, and then we can sculpt the abdomen with the laser at the same time. The recovery, we're seeing less bruising, seeing less swelling, and a more rapid return to their normal activities. Another area that we're finding very exciting is I've been applying this technology to breast lifts and breast reductions. This doesn't change the scarring, but it helps us to sculpt a more lasting shape to the breast, we feel, by reducing the breast volume in ways we can't do with the standard breast lifts.